Hi students, in the previous session we have seen about the electric potential due to an electric dipole. In today's session we are going to see about Biot-Savart law. Before moving to the law, we want to know that in 1819 the great scientist Oersted, he found that the compass needle was deflected by a current carrying wire. Then only he realized that a current carrying wire is associated with a magnetic field, and it is the only way to produce magnetic field. Moreover, the strength of the magnetic field depends on the current, and also it falls off with respect to 1 by r square, where r is the distance of the point from the current carrying wire. Followed by the scientist in 1920, Biot-Savart law, he proposed that a current carrying wire has producing some magnetic induction, and the magnetic induction is due to the force exerted on the point due to the current carrying wire. To know about the Biot-Savart law, let us consider a current carrying wire. It carries the current I. Now let us consider a small element ds on the wire, and due to that element there will be a current element. That means that in that elemental length I is the current flowing through that element, and idl is nothing but the current element. Due to that current element there will be a magnetic induction, that is dB. If we consider a point near to that wire and the distance of the point from the current element is r, therefore dB is the magnetic induction due to that current element. So this dB will be proportional to various parameters. What are all the parameters? We can see one by one. So this dB is proportional to the current carrying wire I, and dB is proportional to elemental length ds, and dB is inversely proportional to r square, and dB is proportional to sine of the angle between the line joining the point and the current element. So if you consolidate all those things, and it is found that dB is proportional to idl sine theta by r square. To remove the proportionality, we can introduce a constant, that is mu naught by 4 pi. Therefore dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi idl sin theta by r square. So this is the magnetic induction due to the small current element. Since dB is a vector quantity, that is magnetic induction is a vector quantity, it is possible to express the expression for magnetic induction due to the small current element in vector notation. So we can write this as dB vector is equal to mu naught by 4 pi ids vector into r cap divided by r square. Here r cap is the unit vector along the line joining the point and the current element. We can replace this r cap by r vector by r. So we can write this as dB vector is equal to mu naught by 4 pi ids vector into r vector divided by r cube. So this is the vector notation of magnetic induction due to the small current element. So the total magnetic induction is equal to the vector sum of the induction due to each and every current element in the wire. It is written as B vector is equal to dB1 vector plus dB2 vector plus dBn vector. So finally we can get the total induction at P due to the entire wire carrying current I. So it is also possible to express the wire in terms of integration, since we are summing up all the induction due to the each and every current element. So we can write this as B vector is equal to integration of mu naught by 4 pi ids vector E cross r vector divided by r square. Therefore the total magnetic induction due to the entire wire carrying current I is given by B vector is equal to integration of dB vector. From the expression it is found that the magnetic field wraps in a circle around the wire. So it is possible to find the direction of the magnetic induction due to the current carrying wire. Using right hand rule we can find the direction. We can keep the right hand like this, so that we can denote the direction of the current carrying wire, and due to that the magnetic field around the wire we can find. Now we can extend this Biot-Savart law to find the magnetic induction due to a long straight conductor carrying current of I. Divide this entire wire into small elemental length and find the magnetic induction at the point which is at a distance of capital R from the current element. From each current element we can find the distance capital R, and also the distance of the current element from the point is given by small r. So this r and small r, we want to calculate the small r means, then r will be equal to s square plus r square. Let us substitute this r in that expression for dB. We already know that dB is equal to mu naught ids vector cross r vector divided by r cube. Now if we substitute for this cross product, then we will get dB is equal to mu naught ids sin theta into r divided by r cube. Therefore, instead of this r sin theta, we can substitute ds. Then if we integrate for finding the total magnetic induction due to the entire wire, we will get the result as B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi capital R. This capital R is the perpendicular distance from the wire carrying current to the point P. Therefore, using this expression, it is possible to find the total magnetic induction due to the long straight conductor carrying current I. Now, it is possible to find the direction of the magnetic induction using Biot-Savart law. Keep your first three fingers of your right hand mutually perpendicular to each other. This denotes the direction of the ds, that is current element, and this denotes the r, the small r, the distance of the point and the current element. Then this thumb will denote the direction of the magnetic induction. So if you see that the magnetic induction is perpendicular to both r and the current element ds. So we found the direction of the magnetic induction due to the current carrying wire using Biot-Savart law. Now we can use the right hand to find the direction of the magnetic induction due to a steady current. Now wrap the wire with your fingers such that the curling of the fingers will denote the magnetic field and the thumb denotes the direction of the current through the wire, that is steady current. So we can use the right hand to find the magnetic induction direction due to a steady current I. It is also possible to find the direction of the magnetic induction due to a current carrying loop. If we consider a loop like this and the current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction such that the centrifugal point will be the distance of the point from the current carrying loop, then if we find the magnetic induction at that point, the direction of the magnetic induction will be perpendicular to the distance of the point from the current carrying loop. Now we can summarize the various results obtained using Biot-Savart law. The first one, the field due to the wires. If you find the magnetic induction due to the wires, then it will be dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi ids cross r cap by r square. Second one, if you find the magnetic induction at the center of the current carrying loop, then it will be B is equal to mu naught I by 2 r. Then if you see that if you find the magnetic induction due to the entire loop of wires containing n turns, then it will be B is equal to mu naught ni by 2 r. And if you find the magnetic induction due to a long straight conductor carrying current, then it will be B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi a. And finally, if you find the force per unit length between the two conductors carrying current I1 and I2 is F is equal to mu naught I1 I2 divided by 2 pi a. Finally, if you want to find the force per unit length between the two wires carrying current I1 and I2, then it will be given by F by L mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi a. So these are the results obtained using Biot-Savart law. Now we came to the end of the session and I hope you understood about the Biot-Savart law and its application. In the upcoming session, we are going to see about Ampere's circuital law. Thank you.